This film is sort of about a travel disaster.
Yes.
I've known you for about 15 years.
Yes.
I feel like when you get into a taxi, things go wrong. When you get on a subway, things
go wrong. It's always a disaster.
You've had so many transit disasters, but you had one of the worst flight stories.
I did. Well, we went to Amsterdam.
Yeah, we lived together in Amsterdam.
Yes. That's right. And I had to fly back home to Chicago, and I could only fly, and I think it was Air Kuwait.
Okay.
And I want to mention them because I do get money from them every time. But I was flying Air Kuwait, and I got on the plane. The minute I got on the plane, the flight had originated somewhere else, and it smelled like feces.
Yeah, okay.
And there was an older man on the plane, you know, and he lost control.
Okay.
He had a problem. And they didn't take him off the plane. They just put, like, a plastic bag over the seat, you know?
Oh.
It was bad. So I'm sitting next to the only other American. Was this woman sitting next to me, and she was like, oh, this airline is the worst. And I was like, yeah, this is awful. And she's like, the last time I was on this airline, the guy next to me died over the ocean. I was like, what happens when the man dies? She's like, nothing. They just put a blanket over him. I'm like, you sat next to a corpse? She's like, yeah, for like 8 hours. I'm like, that can't be. But Air Kuwait has some great specials. If you go to airkuwait.com. They're flying now domestic U.S.
Yeah,
so
this, by the way, they're flying into each other. It's like, look at that. And right now they're doing this.
It's not good.
But you saw the United story and you were inspired.
I've decided I'm going to step up my game financially.
Uh-huh.
Because I don't know if you know that guy settled.
Yeah.
For an undisclosed amount, which...
What do you think the undisclosed amount? We've had this discussion.
$10 million.
You think it's 10?
Here's what I think. I think tonight, I'm flying tonight, and I'm going to get my ass thrown off that plane.
Okay.
And daddy's getting paid.
Yeah.
Yeah. If I were y'all, I would check Twitter about 10 p.m. and see a video of me being, no! And my shirt being pulled
off. Well, I was going to say, I've known you 15 years, and I've seen you with your shirt here. Like 130 times.
But this time I'm getting paid for it. I'm buying my own plane. Yeah.
Wait, I don't know if we told this. We shouldn't say who it is.
Okay.
We're not going to say who it is because you saw a celebrity get dragged off a plane once because of the...
Right. I don't want to say...
Don't say who it was.
I won't say who it was.
But just say that you knew their face.
I knew their face. He was a very famous rapper.
Okay.
From the 80s. That's all I'm going to say.
You're giving away more than I did.
Two hits. And I was like, I heard he was having a medical problem, and they were dragging him off. And I was like, oh, he's going to come right past my aisle. And I was like, oh, don't look. And, like, the minute I turned and looked was the minute he went, and that's how I met Ice-T. It was not Ice-T.
Way more than two hits.
Oh, yeah. But it was bad. It was bad for everyone.
That person is fine.
He's fine now. Yeah. He's great.
I want to ask a mini project. You're coming up. This is the last season, right?
Thank you. Yes. Do you remember when my character in the Mindy Project was a guest on your show?
Yeah. My dog was a guest on the Mindy Project.
My character was a guest on your show, and Frisbee the dog was a guest on the Mindy Project.
And so you worked with Frisbee, and
I think Frisbee is a little uppity bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah. She bit me.
She bit you every take.
Every take she liked, and I was like, hey. And I was kind of like, I've known Frisbee for a little bit.
And it was not helpful for the story how much Frisbee hated you.
Frisbee was, if she would have read her lines, she would have known that we were supposed to be friends and not mortal enemies.
I remember we carved out about 2 hours to shoot, and about 15 minutes you basically said, I think we're good.
I think we got it. Because otherwise, if I get bit one more time, I'm going to have to go get a shot.
Yeah.
But she was really great.
And 100 is... How many episodes are you guys going to end up with?
We're going to end up like 120. And it's funny, we were doing the table read for the 100th episode, right? And I turned to Mindy and I'm like, God, can you believe you were on two different shows that went at least 100 episodes? And she was like, wow, because she was on The Office.
Right, over 100.
And then I thought about it. I was like, oh, wait, so was I. Because I was on Mad TV and then I was on The Mindy Project. And then we made a list of every actor that had been on multiple hundred... It's like 500 people.
Oh, so it wasn't...
The point is, we're not special. We're not good or interesting. We're bad, basic. We're basic bitches, Mindy and I.
I really hope, I'm going to knock on wood, because there's a chance We're both in the Writers Guild. There's a chance that there will be a writer's strike that would start tonight. That would mean this would be the last show before the strike. We're confident.
We don't
want
the strike. I would be excited to be the last show.
Yeah.
Because it'd be the one the most resonant. But I'm hoping there's not a strike. And if there is a strike, I will do commercials for anything.
Okay.
Poison.
Okay.
I'm the face of poison.
This is different than the way you felt 10 years ago during the last one.
Yeah, no, the last one I was like, we're in it to win it. But this one now, I'm like, I got two kids. All right, you got a company that makes, I don't know, machine guns for toddlers? I can sell those. I have the perfect face for that. Hi, I'm Mike Barinholtz for Little Machine Gun. This one has extra ammo holders. That would be, I don't write the copy, so.
Right, okay. I wasn't criticizing you for the copy.
Hey, look, get a slight look.
all right, well, hopefully that doesn't happen.
Yes, yes.
Always great to see you. Congrats on the film.
Thank you, my
Congrats
man.
On everything
Go
else.
Go see it. It's a fun movie.
Always a pleasure. Mike Barinholtz, everybody.